Hey internet, my name is Mark, and if you don't know me already, I'm a senior at NYU studying computer science and linguistics, and I've made quite a few typing videos on this channel. I can type pretty fast, and people tend to like watching them. I have gotten a few comments over the past several months, almost a year now since my first typing video kind of blew up. A lot of them ask about typing special characters, or what I might recommend for proper finger mapping for these special characters. Now, if you're curious about what touch typing is and proper finger mapping, I made a video all about it. You can check in the top right corner. So definitely check that out afterwards, or now, and then come back if you haven't. But today I'm going to be making a relatively short video just on typing special characters. So what exactly defines a special character? Well, I would define a special character as something that shows up a lot in something like computer programming, but also not a lot in your average quote for a typing test. For example, you might get a lot of periods, commas, and question marks, but very rarely will you get literal numbers, or even more rarely will you get curly brackets and parentheses and hyphens and all that. On the topic of numbers, I'm gonna say this a bunch of times throughout the video, but the number row, in my opinion, should just be seen as an extension of the home row method, so whatever fingers that you use should just reach up to those numbers. We'll take a look at keyboard in a second, but nonetheless, let's talk about finger mapping for these special characters. So a lot of these questions came up in the context of the proper finger mapping, or at least what I think is the proper finger mapping relative to home row. So the question is asked, what is the proper finger mapping for typing the special characters on the right of the keyboard, the special characters on the top with the numbers that you just have to hold shift to hit, as well as period, question mark, so on and so forth. So this here is a website called Keyber, and I like to look at this because it's what I would recommend for people who are first getting into touch typing. I have a whole video on different typing websites you can look at if you want to know more about it, but let's just look at their home row diagram for a minute. Pretty plainly, they have the generic home row method. All the numbers on the top, as I mentioned, are an extension of the other three, I guess, rows of the keyboard. But the thing is, everything on the right, so we see the brackets, the vertical bar, backslash, the apostrophe and quotation, the hyphen and plus, those keys are all done with the right pinky according to this diagram. And personally, I don't agree with that because it doesn't feel very functional. As someone who programs, this mapping is not very helpful. I mean, most IDEs, or for the non-programmers, the programs that we use to write code in, autocomplete the parentheses and brackets for you. You open a parenthesis, it'll give you a closing one and work with you on that. All in all, I think that when it comes to typing special characters, if you want to use Keyber's mapping or something of your own, I'll go into what I do in just a minute, it really comes down to your preference, what's most comfortable, and then practicing the absolute heck out of it, because you can't get better at something if you don't practice that thing. There's no secret, it's just finding what's comfortable, what you prefer, and then practicing it. So, what are my favorites and what do I do? When people ask this question, I was like, huh, what do I do? So, we're just gonna look at pastebin really quick, and I'm just gonna kind of be like, here's how I type these numbers. This is simply what my muscle memory is at the moment. When it comes to numbers, if it's 1, 2, or 3, I will hold down the shift key with my left pinky and do 1, 2, or 3 with the ring finger, middle finger, and pointer finger respectively. Maybe with the exception of 4 and 5, but most of the time, I'll just bring my right hand over and 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. Because sometimes if I'm typing out a zip code, it's easier to use one hand just for me. So probably not optimal, but this is just what I prefer. I don't find myself typing numbers that frequently, so it works for me. What you should do, in theory, is if you hold shift for your left pinky, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 should be with your left hand, and 6 through 0 should be with your right hand. And we'll get to the rest of the special characters in just a moment. And by just a moment, I mean right now, because I read my script wrong. So when it comes to the special characters on the right, I probably almost always use my ring finger. When it comes to brackets or even parentheses, I'll use the middle and ring finger on my right hand. So if I'm doing brackets, it's just 1, 2, middle finger, ring finger, I'll just move my whole hand over as opposed to pinky pinky or ring finger pinky, which is probably the best thing to do. So if you're looking for what I think might be the best thing, is probably ring finger pinky for anything that's combined. When it comes to colons and apostrophes, I always use the ring finger. It's just got more strength than the pinky. The apostrophe and the quotation, though, I do use the pinky for. And keep in mind that when I say apostrophe, that's still the pinky. The quotation is just left shift plus the pinky. So when it comes to full sentences, there is a full sentence. I use the ring finger on my right hand for the period. This is going to be a sentence with a comma. I use the ring finger again. That's just my muscle memory. So yeah, kind of unhelpful, but this is simply my opinion. Find something that's comfortable for you, that is functional for how you use special characters, and then practice it. But how, Mark? How can we practice them?
Well, there are two main things I'd recommend. One thing is finding a website like MonkeyType where you can just click on this punctuation thing up here. And if you really want, you can put the numbers thing here. Let's get to late 457 really quick. So under, back, all face, early, ring finger again for that comma. If through both way thing, early, again, ring finger, mean. Using my pinky for the apostrophes, group A, other from whole. Again, ring finger for the period that I missed. Each part. Late, 4 I hit with my left pinky, 5-7 I did pointer middle of my right hand. Late, 3 I did with my pointer finger, 0-6-3. I hit 0 with the ring finger, 6 with my right pointer finger, and 3 with my left pointer finger. Line, hyphen, again ring finger, leave only I 9-9-1-8. Interest, go 8-2 was middle finger and left middle finger. So right middle finger, left middle finger. There are periods and commas here. Those are the important ones. Again, it's functional. If you're someone who wants to type fast so you can, you know, write faster essays or whatever. And, you know, if you're a writer, use typing quotes like this one where you focus on periods and commas and colons and apostrophes, because that's what you'll need. If you're a programmer, you can focus on websites that type code. And that's actually my second tip in general. If we go to a website called speedtyper.dev, and I believe Typeracer also has code snippets in one of their universes or whatever it's called. Whether or not you're a programmer, if you want to simply focus on typing special characters, simply to type special characters faster, typing on a code segment is a fantastic way to do it. So recent high score 65. Let's beat this today. Let's go ahead and just enter a typing race or whatever. The important thing, God, this is gonna be rough. The important thing here is that you don't have to know what the code is saying. You just have to see, oh, it's saying public. Okay, type public. Public t extends enum t json object put string pt enum value throws json exception. Cool, 88 words per minute. All in all, once you find something that's comfortable and that you prefer, just go on to a coding typing test and give it a shot. Just like Monkey types random words, there is no order here. System, good, number, now, they. It's easier when you know what the words are. For example, I can read system and type out system as opposed to typing S-Y-S-T-E-M. And so, you know, when I'm on a coding typing test, it might be a little easier that I understand, okay, function, pure component. If I open parentheses, I'm gonna need to put arguments in here, or parameters, if you will. But all in all, function. Oh look, pure component is two words combined with a capital P and a capital C. This dot props. So, why am I saying type code? Long story short, the only way to get better at typing special characters is to type special characters. Literally, that's it. You wanna get better, find something that works, and practice it. That's all this really comes down to. All in all, there really is no special strategy. There is no secret sauce to, ooh, what's the trick to typing special characters? It's just finding something that's comfortable, and because we type them so much less than usual, even in a code snippet, we saw there are so many more letters and words than there are special characters. It comes down to just practicing it, because the more you practice, the more your muscle memory builds up. The only reason I'm good at special characters is because I program a decent amount. And as we've seen here, I can type at like less than half the speed of my normal typing speed. I can't code at nearly the same speed I can type at, but that's not really the point here. If I were to grind these tests, I'm sure that I could get better and better at it over time. If you want to get better at something, you have to practice it. If you want to get better at chess, practice chess, don't read strategy books. If you want to get better at archery, practice shooting, don't try and lift weights. If you're trying to get better at typing, consciously practice your typing. If you're trying to get better at special characters, practice typing special characters. Now, these two little strategies I outlined in the video are something you can try. I encourage you to try them and just see how they work for a few days or so. If you get better at special characters, fantastic. If you don't, try and find another strategy. I'm sure there's something out there. Hey, everybody, real quick, Mark from the future here on the Discord server, which you can join with a link in the description down below. Someone mentioned this website called typelit.io, and I thought it's a really cool resource. You can type up a bunch of books, so pretty much practice typing while you read. And looking at this passage of Sun Tzu, Lang, oh, it's all capitals. Oh, it's hitting enter. This is the first time I've tried using this. Said is a, right. Okay, this is so cool. Just wanted to mention that because I think it's cool and has some legitimate punctuation occurrences in case you're like me and you're typing for purely functional reasons. I'll leave a link to this in the description down below along with the other sites mentioned in the video. But anyway, let's get back to it.
All comes down to practice. You just have to find what works for you, both in terms of strategy to practice and what the better mapping is for your personal preference.
If there are other strategies out there that you know of that I haven't touched on, please leave them in the comments down below. I read virtually every comment, so if you do, I'll be sure to heart it. If you leave something especially cool, I'll be sure to pin it as well. Anyway, that's it for today. Thanks so much for watching. I hope the fact that I didn't just tell you to practice a bunch discourage you, because really that's all it comes down to. So if you're curious about more typing videos, you can check those out in the top right corner, and I'll have the playlist on screen now. But thanks yet again for watching. Have a good one. And as always, don't forget to stay awesome. See you next week.